35. Where do you think they came from? How come there is no ham in the hamburger? The hamburger originated from a Mongolian tribe, the Tartars, in Central Asia. They ground up meat and mixed it with other vegetables. One day, a Hamburg businessman saw this and introduced it to his hometown. That was how the steak got its present name, hamburger. At first, the tartar steak was for the poor in Germany, but those who came to the United States from Germany made it famous in the U.S. In 1904, at the St. Louis Expo, people started selling the steak with vegetables between two pieces of bread. From then on, people have called this convenient steak with bread a hamburger. At first, this tartar steak was for the poor in Germany, but those who came to the United States from Germany made it famous in the U.S. However, many people didn't know the fact that the word hamburger actually originated from the city of Hamburg, Germany. Many people even thought that there must be ham in the hamburger. From that idea, some smart people came up with the cheeseburger, chicken burger, and even rice burger. How come there's no ham in the hamburger? The hamburger originated from a Mongolian tribe, the Tartars, in Central Asia. They ground up meat and mixed it with other vegetables. One day, a Hamburg businessman saw this and introduced it to his hometown. That was how the steak got its present name, hamburger. At first, the tartar steak was for the poor in Germany, but those who came to the United States from Germany made it famous in the U.S. In 1904, at the St. Louis Expo, people started selling the steak with vegetables between two pieces of bread. From then on, people have called this convenient steak with bread a hamburger. At first, tartar steak was for the poor in Germany, but those who came to the United States from Germany made it famous in the U.S. However, many people didn't know the fact that the word hamburger actually originated from the city of Hamburg, Germany. Many people even thought that there must be ham in the hamburger. From that idea, some smart people came up with the cheeseburger, chicken burger, and even rice burger. How come there's no ham in the hamburger? The hamburger originated from a Mongolian tribe, the Tartars, in Central Asia. They ground up meat and mixed it with other vegetables. One day, a Hamburg businessman saw this and introduced it to his hometown. That was how the steak got its present name, hamburger. At first, the tartar steak was for the poor in Germany, but those who came to the United States from Germany made it famous in the U.S. In 1904, at the St. Louis Expo, people started selling the steak with vegetables between two pieces of bread. From then on, people have called this convenient steak with bread a hamburger. At first, tartar steak was for the poor in Germany, but those who came to the United States from Germany made it famous in the US. However, many people didn't know the fact that the word hamburger actually originated from the city of Hamburg, Germany. Many people even thought that there must be ham in the hamburger. From that idea, some smart people came up with the cheeseburger, chicken burger, and even rice burger. Where did ice cream come from? Many people seem to believe that ice cream was invented in Italy. Believe it or not, however, China was where ice cream was first. Iced milk that was made from mixing snow and milk. That was how ice cream started. Following China, the Italians started eating iced milk and fruit in the 14th century. Considered priceless, the recipe for ice cream was kept secret. But the recipe was passed on to France from Italy by Catherine de' Medici, who brought cooks to make ice cream for her parties. After freezing skills were developed in the 1560s, a large amount of ice cream could be made. Blasius Villafranca, a Spanish doctor in Rome, found that by mixing salt with snow and ice, the temperature would drop to the freezing point in no time. That was when fully frozen ice cream was first made. Where did ice cream come from? Many people seem to believe that ice cream was invented in Italy. Believe it or not, however, China was where ice cream was first iced milk that was made from mixing snow and milk. That was how ice cream started. Following China, the Italians started eating iced milk and fruit in the 14th century. Considered priceless, the recipe for ice cream was kept a secret. But the recipe was passed on to France from Italy by Catherine de' Medici, who brought cooks to make ice cream for her parties. After freezing skills were developed in the 1560s, a large amount of ice cream could be made. Blasius Villafranca, a Spanish doctor in Rome, found that by mixing salt with snow and ice, the temperature would drop to the freezing point in no time. That was when fully frozen ice cream was first made. Where did ice cream come from? Many people seem to believe that ice cream was invented in Italy. Believe it or not, however, China was where ice cream was first iced milk that was made from mixing snow and milk. That was how ice cream started. Following China, the Italians started eating iced milk and fruit in the 14th century. Considered priceless, the recipe for ice cream was kept a secret. But the recipe was passed on to France from Italy by Catherine de' Medici, who brought cooks to make ice cream for her parties. After freezing skills were developed in the 1560s, a large amount of ice cream could be made. Blasius Villafranca, A Spanish doctor in Rome found that by mixing salt with snow and ice, the temperature would drop to the freezing point in no time. That was when fully frozen ice cream was first made. What kind of dog is the hot dog? When hot dogs were first sold in the United States in the 1860s, Americans called them Dachshund sausages. It was because they looked like a Dachshund, a dog from Germany with a very long body and short legs. Dachshund sausages first became popular in New York. People sold them at baseball games. Keeping them warm in hot water tanks, the sellers shouted, "Get your hot Dachshund sausages." People enjoyed eating the sausages on bread while watching baseball games. In 1906, Tad Dorgan, a newspaper cartoonist, drew bread with a Dachshund inside instead of a Dachshund sausage. The problem was that he didn't know how to spell Dachshund, so he wrote, "Get your hot dogs." The cartoon became popular, and so did the new name. That was how the hot dog got its name. What kind of dog is the hot dog? When hot dogs were first sold in the United States in the 1960s, Americans called them Dachshund sausages. It was because they looked like a Dachshund, a dog from Germany with a very long body and short legs. Dachshund sausages first became popular in New York. People sold them at baseball games. Keeping them warm in hot water tanks, the sellers shouted, "Get your hot Dachshund sausages!" People enjoyed eating the sausages on bread while watching baseball games. In 1906, Tad Dorgan, a newspaper cartoonist, drew bread with a Dachshund inside instead of a Dachshund sausage. The problem was that he didn't know how to spell Dachshund, so he wrote, "Get your hot dogs!" The cartoon became popular, and so did the new name. That was how the hot dog got its name. What kind of dog is the hot dog? When hot dogs were first sold in the United States in the 1960s, Americans called them Dachshund sausages. It was because they looked like a Dachshund, a dog from Germany with a very long body and short legs. Dachshund sausages first became popular in New York. People sold them at baseball games. Keeping them warm in hot water tanks, the sellers shouted, "Get your hot Dachshund sausages!" People enjoyed eating the sausages on bread while watching baseball games. In 1906, Tad Dorgan, a newspaper cartoonist, drew bread with a Dachshund inside instead of a Dachshund sausage. The problem was that he didn't know how to spell Dachshund, so he wrote, "Get your hot dogs." The cartoon became popular, and so did the new name. That was how the hot dog got its name.